Hello, welcome to our Exotic Pets Sanctuary. How can I help you? Okay, so you want to adopt a pet? Wonderful. Do you have already something in mind or you need some help? Okay, you like herbivores? Mm-hmm. Let's see, do you have a garden? Okay, a little one, okay. Oh, so you already have a rabbit. Okay, so I would recommend guinea pigs because they are really comfortable around bunnies. Yes, they are really good friends, but we prefer them to be adopted at least in pairs because they are gregarious animals and they can suffer loneliness, you know, so we prefer them to be two or more. Of course, I can give you some useful information, okay, and then you can meet Draco and Harry. That are they are two really lovely guinea pigs, and they are brothers. So yeah, they're about 2 years old. Okay, I just want you to have all the information before you decide to adopt them. Okay. So I'll write everything on this paper as well, so you can take it with you, okay? So let's start with the food that you need, that guinea pigs will need. So vegetables, and especially pepper, because pepper has vitamin C. Lettuce, salad, cucumber, okay? Then you will see what they prefer. The important thing is that there is not seeds in their food. They have plenty of water. They take water from food as well, but it's important that they have it as well. Then they always have to have some straws in their cage or when you keep them, because they need straws for their teeth, you know, so they always need to use their teeth. It's very important. And then the dry food, you will need to buy some dry food as well. Recommend the Osmo croquettes. And also from Oxbow, some vitamin C croquettes as well, just if they do not eat pepper, you can give them those. So then let's see where you will keep them. You can keep them in cages, but they have to be at least 1 meter for 50 centimeters. They have to be at least like these, so the bigger the better. So let me write this for you. Okay, and outside you can put them aside, but of course no temperature changes, you know, not too much. So you, it's better not to put them in cages inside your house, and then outside, and then inside. It's not okay. So you, it's preferable to them for to be outside or inside, you know. In the case you keep them in cage, let's see. Case maintenance. All right, some useful information. Because maybe you want to keep them in your garden free, but maybe you go on holiday and you will, they will be staying in cages. So I write that to you. So just to be sure that you know what to do. To you know, be sure that they are comfortable in a cage. You can use mats, reusable mats, you know, or pellet, so they can be comfortable. And especially I recommend some Facebook groups when you can buy some beautiful mats with a lot of drawings, reusable. They are reusable, or you can use just pellet and change it whenever you want. But I recommend to use these Facebook groups so you can talk with some people and get some ideas and see what's better for you and your pets. So. Alright, some names for you of these groups. Okay, so I'll write also some do nots for you. So do not lift them too much. This is important. But you have to engage with them. So you don't have to traumatize them, so just don't lift them too much or too suddenly, but it's okay for you to pet them, to lift them a little bit sometimes, but just take it easy because they are really afraid. So, and it's really important that if you want to put them in the same space, you need to sterilize them first, especially for them, because they are two males. So okay, so I think you can hear them right now because they are hungry and they do that sound. You can hear them. They want food. So, yeah, so sterilize them. I can recommend some doctors that. That in the cages or in the garden, wherever you put them, they have some hiding place where they can hide. So, like wood houses or something like that, you can check on the Facebook groups that I told you, because you'll find a lot of information, a lot of shops, online shops as well. So, here you are. And then other important information, they hear them, they're screaming really. They need food, yeah. Yeah, I know, it's really cute. It's a really cute sound. So just check, you need to go to a vet expert in exotic animals. I will say once a year or every 6 months, is everything is okay. So pet checks once a year or every 6 months. You if you don't want to go to the vet every time, you need to check their nails, so you have to cut them. They don't shouldn't grow too much, but you have to be very careful when you cut the nails, because you don't have to go too near to their little paws, you know? So, because it's dangerous, so if you're not sure how to do that, just go to the vet, or we offer this service if you're interested, okay? Then you need always to check their feet. You just take them and check their feet. You'll find a lot of YouTube videos about this, how to do that. But feel free to call our center or sanctuary so you can show you how many times you want, okay? It's really easy. And they clean themselves, so you won't need to clean them. But sometimes if you want, you can use some water to clean your pads, or, you know, okay? You can hear them chewing the wood houses. It's really important that they do that, so that's really good to see. Okay, so, this is yours. And I hope I told you everything, but please feel free to call our sentry whenever you want. And also you can find a lot of info on our website with some recommendation about beds or clinics. And I'm going to show you the beds now, okay? This is Draco, and is a really curious guinea pig, really, and as you can see it's a really funny and nice guinea pig. As you can see, they have the hiding space. There is their straws here that they love, some croquettes, and they will eat in a bit. It's almost dinner time. Here the water. Right now we are using like this kind of mats for them, but there is pellet under it. And this is Harry. He's really shy. It's a really, really, really shy guinea pig, but you will learn to that when he wants, he will go on his wooden house and he will ask to be petted. Yeah, I know they are adorable, so I'm really happy that you like them. So I just need some basic info from you, like your name and surname, email address, and a number, telephone number, perfect. When you'll come picking them up tomorrow, please come with two separate carriers, okay? The ones for cats are fine. No, we don't take money. Absolutely. If you want, you can donate on our website, but it's your choice. Okay? I have got all the information that you need. So, see you soon then, and